Osuna, Bernard Hopkins, and Beto Duran. The Triple Bs here from the StubHub Center in Carson. And you could feel the tension. You can feel the anticipation, B-Hop, because Ryan Garcia, he's got over 800,000 followers on Instagram. But this is not social media. This is boxing. This is
boxing. It's a little chilled here in StubHub, and let me tell you something, it's going to get warm real quick.
Jason Velez not afraid at all, not intimidated by Ryan Garcia, his speed, his power, nothing. You can see the height of Ryan Garcia immediately against the former world title challenger. He said, I'll make my adjustments on the fly. I'll let him come to me, and as the rounds progress, I'll start doing what I need to do.
And he's doing that. I mean, both guys are really like trying to set up a position where they can go ahead and take control. The first two rounds is going to be a round of who going to dictate it going forward, but not actually be the case in this fight, because both guys are going to have their rounds.
Chavela is trying to work the body, trying to tie up Ryan Garcia. He said, I want to do things to him in the ring that he hasn't seen before. I want to take him deep. I want him to think. And Ryan Garcia says, don't worry, I'll make my adjustments as the fight progresses, and I'll make him pay.
Velez is showing that aggressive and veteran move. He wants to stay close, and he wants to keep the pressure on Garcia, the younger and the most, you know, inexperienced out of the two.
You look at the back of Ryan Garcia, already the right hand to the body of Jason Velez, making its presence known. Brash predictions from Ryan Garcia. Now he's got to make it come true inside the ring. And Velez says, look, this fight is a test for me because they want to prove that he's for real. And I need to prove that I'm not finished as a true prospect and that I can once again become a world champion. We see the right hand of Ryan Garcia lightning quick. But Velez has something for him because he's coming back with something.
Velez is staying just close enough to be able to counter when Garcia, or if Garcia misses. If he misses and he don't protect himself, he will get countered, because if you see how Velez is just sitting there waiting and just in the right distance to get a punch off, whether it's right hand, left hand, and he's staying close to be able to do that.
And you see the body shot from Jason Velez. Protect yourselves at all time is the old boxing adage. There you see the overhand right. So Velez came to fight.
Garcia's getting hit with that right hand because he's throwing one jab and he's not bringing it up. He has to double the jab up. That would make Velez be kind of leery on coming in with a counter if there's two or three jabs coming.
You see a nice left hook landed by Ryan Garcia. We remind you that Jason Velez has never been stopped as a pro. He's got a good chin, and that's what he said. Let's see when I take his shots how Ryan Garcia reacts as the fight progresses, as round one comes to an end.
Neil, you're letting him take you back a little bit, just a little bit, but you're good. You're good, you know what I mean? Stick that jab in his face. He's gonna try to come in, stick that jab, you're gonna do a combo, jab, boom, boom. Get that jab uppercut, it's there. Okay, because he's coming in. He's coming in with his head down. So you can easily look at him, pop, pop, uppercut. Just like the simulation, okay? Other than that, it's good, but don't let him take you back, all right?
Ready for round two here at the StubHub Center in Carson, where Ryan Garcia, he's used to disposing of his opponents early on. In his pro career, he's got 6 first round knockouts out of the 13 he has as a pro. So Jason Velez, proving at least durable here early on in the fight. And the one thing about Velez is he came to fight. He's got something as an answer for every time that Ryan Garcia throws something, he knows something's coming back.
Well, Garcia has to be careful not to try to come out like he came out in opponents before. Velez is a cagey. He stayed close enough, and he's waiting for Garcia to throw a punch and bring his hands down low and not protect himself because he's waiting to counter. If he's got his hands up, Velez wants to counter with any hand, left or right. Look for him to do that, body shots, and then a counter.
The gear that Ryan Garcia is wearing, well, he's got Frida Kahlo, he's got Dia de los Muertos, he's wearing part of a sarape in his robe, all in honor of Cinco de Mayo.
This is where Jason Velez is really dangerous and can have Garcia really fighting in a way of keeping him off him, which is not going to be a good thing. Garcia must continue keeping him in the center of the ring, Velez, and throw combinations and not get trapped on the ropes like he's getting trapped now.
Right? Nice and relaxed.
The one thing that Ryan's father was asking for in the corner, Henry Garcia, who's also his trainer, I want more jazz. Is that's not really in the arsenal from what we've seen in Ryan Garcia's repertoire. He's more of a power puncher. He doesn't use the jab like many other fighters, and that's something that you would like to see someone develop. And speaking of corners, Beto Duran was in the corner of Jason Velez. What did they say? All right, we haven't opened Beto's mic as of yet. But nonetheless, Ryan Garcia connects with a nice left and right. You see the leg of Jason Velez turn into jello early on in round two.
Ryan Garcia has power. And he shows that power when he put punches together. If he continue to set it up off the jab, we might see Velez do more of them funny dances as the fight goes on in rounds.
And Jason Velez is right in his face once again. And there's a low blow from Velez. That's the caginess of a fighter, B-Hop. You've been there, done that. As now they go at it on the break. That's what he wants to do, is bring Ryan Garcia into his fight.
And pick him apart. Because Velez is going to try to suck him into a war.
Solid round here from the StubHub Center between Garcia and Velez.
So you did very good precision this round, okay? Next round, start throwing some, open up a little bit with the combination. You'll get him confused, and then he'll be like, fuck it
up. Hear me? Llévalo a la esquina, poco a poco, no tienes que tirarte de allá atrás. Poco a poco. Está bien, poco a poco. Sí, tú sigues joseando. Y si metes la mano abajo, saca la recta arriba. Right. Respira hondo.
No, la boquilla.
La boquilla. This is it, seconds out.
Ryan Garcia is in elite company with ESPN.com's Prospects of the Years for the last 5 years. Erickson Lubin went in 2016, and then world champion Errol Spence Jr., Felix Verdejo, the Olympian from Puerto Rico, as well as Vasily Lomachenko, who's considered by many as the top pound-for-pound fighter in the world. He won the award in 2013. So he's looking to prove that he belongs amongst those names, B-Hop. And boy, what a list that is.
It is. And you know, there's two ways that both of these fighters know how they got to win this fight and also establish that now.
Right.
Garcia has to be in the middle of the ring and doing what he's doing now with that jab, but he has to throw more than one. And Velez know that he has to keep him on the ropes and make it a really dirty and a really fight that's going to be ugly. And so that's his chance, Velez, to get a good punch in on Garcia, hoping that Garcia get frustrated, get tired.
Nice left hand there from Jason Velez, what were the instructions for Ryan Garcia in between rounds, Beto?
Just like that, Bernard. Throw jab. Now his dad said open up. I asked him, what does that mean? He said throw more combinations. He just wants to see Ryan put 3-4 at a time.
Nice right hand there to the chin of Velez, who once again, we remind you, he's never been stopped as a pro, but already twice, we've seen him do the stanky leg dance, B-Hop.
Garcia is setting up a right uppercut or a left uppercut after those combinations that was mentioned earlier. The combinations must be in the center of the ring, and Garcia must finish with an uppercut, whether it's a left hand or right hand, or Velez is going to run right into those shots. Velez has to be on an angle not to get hit with that uppercut that he just ran into just now.
There you see the speed of Ryan Garcia, able to create space and try to take advantage. And Velez coming in with the head. He wants to frustrate Ryan Garcia. He told us in the fighter meetings, I want to make him think. I don't want him to think that he can just do what he wants to do against lesser fighters. He's facing me. I'm a grown man, and he's going to find that out in the ring.
And he has one of the awkward, not pretty styles. So the way he's fighting has been successful in his career.
Get your hand up, Jace.
You know, this is where a young fighter like Garcia has to figure out with that right uppercut that I mentioned earlier.
There it is. And once again, you see the legs of Jason Velez go a little weak, and here comes Ryan Garcia. He said before 4 rounds, this fight would be over. The fans start to get on their feet here at the StubHub Center. And we'll remind you of one thing. Jason Velez was on the brink of retiring. He was working at a fast food chicken place in Puerto Rico, and he said, this is not who I am. I'm a fighter. So there's a lot at stake for him and for his family here this evening.
And he still was training as he was working, anticipating maybe an opportunity like this, Bernardo, because he's still game, he's still coming in. And you know what? Garcia did not underestimate him and think that because he hit him with an easy shot, that it's over. Well, both guys giving and taking, want that win, each of them want that win just as bad as they win at the first one.
And so does Velez, who comes out fighting after a very rough third round. This is where Ryan Garcia tried to pull a Muhammad Ali and call his round. That sometimes puts undue pressure on a young fighter.
But he's trying, and to have that courage and want to go out there and then see it physically, I mean, if you can back it up, it all makes him great.
But do you see Velez wearing down here in the fourth round behind? His demeanor, his body language?
Velez got hit with some good shots, and he realized
great
that he's
fight
in
here at
there
the StubHub Center tonight. Next week, we're at the Madison Square Garden
really means
for
what
a championship fight.
And
Joe Tessitore with the preview.
Punches can change your mind when they hit you.
All right, in Velez's corner, it was William Cruz giving instructions. Beto, what was he telling the Puerto Rican fighter?
And Bernard, you talked about those big punches. They asked him, how do those feel? Velez said he has some power on it, but the second one wasn't as strong as the first one. His instruction for this round, encimalo, smother him. Get in front of Ryan.
Let him go. Back
that's exactly what he wants to do. And there's that quick overhand right from Ryan Garcia. One of the things that impresses me about this young man is how he's able to create space and take advantage of it.
That impresses me, but also I go back to that right uppercut. What impresses me is when he see that he getting some mileage out of things that he's doing, he goes back to that. Maybe not right away, but he goes back to what got a reaction. You know, when he got reaction, he bounced on it, and he just threw an uppercut not too long ago, trying to get the same reaction. That is poise. That is a young fighter who believes in himself and know what he needs to do.
One of the other things being that Jason Velez is a more experienced fighter with his 32nd professional fight this evening. You see Ryan Garcia trying to set things up. He's not just going after him like he would against a fighter of a lesser level. I mean, he's respecting the skill of Jason Velez, who one day was also a young, brash, undefeated fighter for Puerto Rico. But nonetheless, he knows what his job is tonight.
Garcia is sitting in the pocket, and he's continuing to throw that off the right jab, off the left jab, a right uppercut, combination, spins off the ropes and go in the middle of the ring. That's ring generalship. When you see ring generalship, you know that he's not only having fun, but he's also using all the mechanics that he knows from the amateurs down in the pros. And that's what I'm impressed by.
Ryan Garcia was supposed to be on the Canelo Triple G undercard. Fortunately for us, that fight did not happen. And so here he is headlining on Golden Boy Boxing on ESPN, trying to show the world what King Rai, the Flash, is all about as round four comes to an end.
Up at the bell. Good, man. All right. He's very confused right now. If you throw those combos, you open up, you're gonna stop him. But you have to do it. Okay? Right? It's good. And when you go back, you leave yourself up, all right? Don't leave yourself open. All right? Not those punches. And if you have to work.
Bernard Osuna, Bernard Hopkins, and Beto Duran coming to you live from the StubHub Center in Carson. Tonight's main event features undefeated Ryan Garcia taking on Jason Velez. And this is territory that Velez expected to be in and to be taking Ryan Garcia into. What did you observe from Ryan Garcia in the first four rounds as we hear the fans go crazy for a second?
He handled what? He handled the pressure of Velez. And right now, Garcia is standing in the pocket waiting to counter Velez like he just did.
So far, overhand right now.
So yes, but so far Garcia is passing a test that I think the world wanted to see if he can pass, and that is how he reacts when the pressure by Velez be pressured round by round by round. How do he change Velez's thinking and make him fight a fight that he's not used to? And that is trying to box or trying to find a way to counter.
All right, Beto, this fight got into the fifth round. Ryan said it wouldn't, but it is here. What were the instructions in the corner?
His dad said this is the fight the dad expected. Obviously, he said Velez is really experienced. They want Ryan to start going to the body because they see how Velez is trying to get inside. He said get to the body, attack the body. That was emphasis for this round.
Thank you very much to our inside reporter, Beto Duran. And I mean, just a reminder, just Ryan Garcia is the hottest thing since sliced bread in terms of young prospects, but this was once the story of Jason Velez, who had a stellar amateur career, and he recalls that, and he says, I was once that guy. I ended up working at a fast food place, so anything can happen in the sport. And one punch can change it all, as we see right there, another right hand that makes Velez's legs wobble.
Velez spoke about that, and you know, we see Garcia as a guy that thinks he's invincible, and he wants to change that because he knows the thinking of that because he's been in that situation.
Velez's observation of Ryan Garcia as he lands two overhands rights. Big right hand there. Three overhand rights for Ryan Garcia, but there's Velez, who has never been stopped as a professional. He's got four losses, but he's always seen the final bell. And that's why for Ryan Garcia, this is about proving a point, proving that he is better than anybody else who's ever stepped into the ring against Jason Velez.
And he wants to continue to what? Tell people that he's here, and he's here for a long time. And even though fourth round and fifth now that we are in, he's still going to try, I see, the way he's throwing punches, trying to get a knockout. But he must be careful of Velez.
You see Ryan Garcia, very accurate. 18 knockouts and 26 wins for Jason Velez from Juncos, Puerto Rico. Mexico, Puerto Rico on Cinco de Mayo weekend. That's what you've got in tonight's main event on Golden Boy Boxing on ESPN.
Jason. Jason. Dame un favor. Cuando estés en el agarre, tú tienes la fuerza de romper el agarre. Hazle daño cuando estés en el agarre. Rómpelo.
Es lo único que está haciendo para agarrar.
Dale.
Tienes que tirarle ahí. Empújalo, sácalo de encima, que haga fuerza. Está
haciendo un buen trabajo.
Y tú menos grasa.
Está haciendo un buen trabajo.
Ya, vas ahí, ¿no? Solo métesela bien. Tienes que
que subir el paso ahora.
No me lo guía.
Quédate con la cabeza en el pecho y no dejes que te lleve a la cuerda.
Come on, man.
Use your skill. Use your skill.
Oscar De La Hoya ringside, but look who's just a couple seats next to him. It's former UFC heavyweight champion Chuck Liddell, who was in the Golden Boy offices today.
All right, step
They're
back.
Talking about a bright future moving forward, boxing and UFC, B-Hop.
Hey, listen, I love it. Whatever brings fans to the table and the TV.
Well, Ryan Garcia does that too. So I'm sure Golden Boy Boxing is happy as one of the partners in the company. I mean, Ryan Garcia is probably getting more out of this type of fight than he would out of a quick knockout here in his 15th pro bout.
Experience. And experience will go a long way, way past this fight. And Ryan Garcia, look at the combinations. One punch, I think he should add more punches, because when he's throwing combinations, he seems to be sharper, quicker, and he seems to get the last two or three punches in. But look, Velez is one of those pretty in the alley type of guys who's going to maul you inside like he's doing now to Garcia.
This is the fight that Garcia's corner envisioned, but it's also the fight that Jason Velez envisioned. I mean, he knew he had to walk through fire. He had to walk through the power of this young fighter, but so far, he's been able to withstand the punishment. Let's take a look at the total power punches thrown so far. It's actually very even when you look at the number thrown, just three difference. But look at the punches landed, almost twice as many for Ryan Garcia at a 34% clip, with 56 landed so far through the first five rounds of action.
Younger, quicker, and fighting more of his style.
Deep breath,
then Velez. Velez somewhere in these rounds, he has to change the style, because it will continue to repeat himself round by round by round, because Garcia is going to continue to do what he's doing. Quick punches, right hand, left hand, and beat him to the punch, and sneak that uppercut in there every now and then.
Stop, Jason. Stop! Right? Deep breath.
Ryan Garcia having to think things through here, and he lands a nice uppercut as Velez tried to get aggressive, and he's paying the price here in the sixth round. Nice left hook from Ryan Garcia, who starts to unload his power punches, and the fans start to get on their feet here at the StubHub Center.
That gotta be very, very discouraging, because you get one punch in and you get hit with 10 punches and he takes that play away. That is Garcia. I mean, Velez has to continue to press forward, but he got to press forward and do something different, or he's going to be get picked off before he can get a punch off.
Look at that wily veteran move being below the belt when the referee is on the other side. That's something that Bernard Hopkins would appreciate, as we're going to stay here and listen in to Henry Garcia give the instructions to his son, Ryan Garcia. Let's go into the corner for the Hennessy Never Stop, Never Settle corner kick.
That's what you want to do. And you can only do that when you're throwing those combinations, because he gets frustrated. So when he gets frustrated, now you have more opportunities. Okay, so please continue. Stay in the center of the ring and throw those combinations, okay?
Don't move back.
Okay? You got to break the momentum. You don't even have to clinch or anything. He's coming in. Step to the side. Circle him. And then open up.
Good deep breath.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah. All right. So he's coming in like that. So you got to spin out immediately. But don't stay by the rope. Stay in the center of the ring. And I'll box the heck out of him. Come on. You're doing good, Neil. You're doing good. All right. Come on, Ryan.
All right, B-Hop. So they're happy with what he's doing, but they want some more.
And he's staying in the middle of the ring. He's letting his hands go. Garcia sees everything that's coming at him, because Velez is throwing one punch and he's throwing slow punches. And so when you got that with a younger guy, a prospect like Garcia, he's going to counter. He's going to throw three or four punches. Velez has to keep the fight close so those quick punches won't be effective to him. But I doubt if he can withstand the speed and the ring generalship that Garcia is putting on him right now.
But he's coming out strong, pressuring is Jason Velez.
Back, and
So Beto, what were the instructions for the Puerto Rican fighter in his corner?
As they said in the corner, super bien, as the Boricuas would say, he's good. They told him to put the pressure. They said that he told us yesterday in the meetings that he knew that Ryan Garcia never gone extra rounds. He wanted to take him deep waters. The corner said that they want Jason to do exactly this. Stay nice and tight, cover up on that uppercut that Ryan's trying to land.
You see now the blood trickling from the right side of the face of Jason Velez. Corner did a good job in terms of that, but there's that overhand right that once again finds a home behind the ear of Jason Velez. But the chin of Velez holding up so far, behind.
Yes, holding up, but his face is getting marked and the rounds are really ticking by. You know, Jason Velez is being told in his corner to do what? Keep the pressure. But keeping pressure and not actually moving your hand and making something out of that pressure is just basically running into with Garcia's run into him so he can throw his combination. And Garcia will do that all day long. He'll continue to throw punches as Velez walk in like he's doing now.
Again, he catches him with the right hand coming in. And then the left hook from Ryan Garcia. Now Velez told us Ryan Garcia has two gears. He comes forward or he goes backward. He doesn't know how to fight laterally. That's what I'm gonna try to make him do tonight. And nice left hook there from Jason Velez. He's trying to find that second win. Catch that second win.
But what Ryan Garcia is doing now, he might not be moving laterally, but he's moving in circles. He's moving from the left to the right. As you see him moving now, he's not trapping himself in the corner as much as he was early in the fight.
He said, I make adjustments as the fight progresses. Not so much in sparring, but once the fight starts, I see what my opponent has, and I learn his weaknesses, and I exploit them.
Well, a couple of rounds early, it was in the second gear. Now I think he's in the fourth and fifth gear because he looks fresher, he looks sharper, he sees everything. And right now, they're just like, you know, trying to set Velez up with maybe another right uppercut because he sees everything. He sees everything Velez is throwing.
Playing the matador there in that scene where Velez is coming forward with his head and he gets caught. Once again by Ryan Garcia, the flash, speed, power, and charisma.
I like to see Garcia throw body shots more.
The other button.
Okay, don't take any mean chances. He's already cut. You could tap him, but this has got to be the one. The right's going to be the one. Don't bag. You don't have to. You got your keeper.
Round 8 of a scheduled 10-rounder. Now, Jason Velez accomplished something very important. He's taking Ryan Garcia into deep waters. That's your specialty, B-Hop. When you were a champion defending the world title 20 times as a middleweight, this is what you did. What's it like when you succeed in doing what you came out to do?
Well, one is you set your feet, you plant yourself, you get power shots in more than quick shots. You take a little bit of speed off the punch, and you put more power by what? Getting in position, maybe squatting down a little bit, maybe getting in a position to throw a left hook and a left hook position. Feet planted in the ground, as we always say, and let the punches cause power punches. Because now you're in the deep water, and now you want to see what the guy has, and can he keep up with you? And that's important to be able to let him know that you switched to him up again.
All right, Beto Duran, our third man on this broadcast team, is taking us into the corner, round in and round out. Beto, what were the instructions for Ryan?
This isn't deep water for Ryan Garcia. They said mentally they trained for 12 rounds. They're not worried about everybody saying, this is deep water. No concern in his corner.
All right, so Ryan Garcia, the youth, the crashes, the confidence in the corner as the wave starts to roll up here at the StubHub Center in Carson. It's the wave of Velez coming forward that Ryan Garcia will have to deal with. As Velez said, I'm conditioned. I stopped working at the fast food place. I dedicated myself to boxing for this fight. This is my last hurrah.
Stop!
Through the first seven rounds of the fight, these are the total punches thrown. And 90 more thrown from Ryan Garcia. And almost 60 more landed for the fighter from Southern California. The percentage at 28. He's got some respect for Velez, but he also wants to keep breaking him down, B-Hop.
Well, he got to keep breaking him down, and he got to change up from just hitting me with an uppercut. Garcia has a good right hook. That right hook should have been thrown right there, because when you make Velez miss, he must throw a punch to make him pay. You make him miss, you make him pay. And he has set him up really smartly. He can't set him up just throwing power shots.
All right. Garcia with his back to the rope there. The quickness of that left hook. You know, it doesn't have to be a jab when you're that fast and your reflexes are lightning quick. You can get away with switching your offense up, and that's something that is very tough to teach a young fighter, but Ryan's got this.
That left hook from Garcia is like a whip. When he throws it, and it's quick and it's fast.
10 seconds, stop at the bell. Nos robaron ese asalto. Nos robaron. Óyeme, llega primero en pierna. ¿Qué asalto es este? Este es el nuevo, ¿verdad? ¿Cómo tú te sientes? Respira, vamos. Óyeme, cuando estés en el clinch, métele el open y métele la bola corto. No tienes que cargarlo.
We're in the corner of Jason Velez as he receives instructions from William Cruz. Come on, let's go get him. You gotta attack. This is your moment. Here, I need my mouthpiece. Let's go, use your leg. Go get him, you gotta throw punches. You can do this, go get him. All right, that was the Hennessy corner cam. Never stop, never settle. And that's exactly what William Cruz wants out of Jason Velez, who's taken Ryan Garcia to unknown territory. This is the first time in his career that King Rai, the Flash, has ever seen the ninth round. And what's that like as a young prospect when you're getting into territory you never have been into?
Deep waters, that is. But, you know, Garcia is handling that deep water. To me, he handled, if I was at the gradient, I'll say about a B, B minus, because not only is he still poised, but both guys, even Velez, he's not breathing. Garcia is not breathing hard, like, you know, they're exhausted. Both guys are still a little fresh in these rounds, where both of them can hurt each other if they get a good shot in. But I'm really pleased at Garcia's poise and how he's circling and not going back to the ropes, getting trapped. Velez must change the strategy in his mind how he's going to approach Garcia, because Garcia is aware what he's doing, coming forward for no punches. And so he's going to continue to circle to his left and right. What Velez needs to do is just trap him and actually bum rush him to the corner and just let all his hands go like he tried to do. But Garcia is slipping. He got it right out of it.
Nice combination there from Ryan Garcia, who was hearing it from the crowd because he was moving laterally, trying to get a little fancy here. And hey, this is a StubHub Center. The crowd does not play that boxing stuff here. No fine boxing, no stylistic boxing. They want a war.
Well, they'd have booed me the first second the fight was started, because I got to see what I'm working with and get my vision right.
Ryan Garcia got his vision right there with a nice uppercut. But Velez, we talked about his durability. He was called into this fight for a reason, to give Ryan Garcia rounds, experience, and a challenge, and that's exactly what the Puerto Rican has poised this evening against Ryan Garcia. A challenge, and Ryan Garcia is in for a fight this evening.
What I like about Velez, he continued to come forward. You know, he's not as talented all-around fighter like a young prospect of Garcia. But far as his heart, far as he's determined to still try to plug and plug and plug, and maybe something happened, maybe he gets a shot in. He never took a step back and get frustrated. And that's what I like about Valdez.
Nice right hand there from Ryan Garcia. And here Ryan Garcia is just trying to shine, and the fans are still with him. Garcia. You know, Velez is coming off of a huge win against former champion Juanma Lopez. Oh, big right hand from Ryan Garcia. Almost comes at the bell. Golden Boy Boxing on ESPN is presented by Tika, the official beer of boxing. Shot we're seeing from overhead here at the StubHub Center in Carson. And this is the first time that Ryan Garcia goes to the 10th round. Let's listen in to Henry Garcia, his father's instruction.
Stay focused, stay in the center. Open up. Open up, Ryan. Last round. Last round, man. Shoulder skills now. You got this, all right? This championship now. This is it, man. This is what you did since 7 years old. Come on. Let's do this. Come on. Let's go.
They're happy with what they're seeing, but there's no doubt, B-Hop, that Henry Garcia wants his son to go out and put on a show.
I think he wants to stop it. He said, you've been doing this, Garcia, since you were 7 years old. And you know what? You've been in deep waters now. Without a life jacket, let's go. Let's get him.
No training wheels, no life jacket, no floaties. This is the 10th and final round of the Garcia-Velez main event alongside Bernard Hopkins and Beto Duran. I'm Bernardo Osuna coming to you from the StubHub Center in Carson, where Velez once again proves his durability against Ryan Garcia, making the young prospect put in a workmanlike evening. And he takes a nice left hook from Velez and says, hey, protect yourself at all times, kid.
That veteran move. Look, all right, let's go. Here's a guy, you know, young, don't know, backs his hand, put his hands down, backs up like the referee is going to say, okay, fight. Listen, you must protect yourself, and one shot could have changed everything.
Always a learning experience. And
stop. Break.
Keep Ryan Garcia walked in to the StubHub Center wearing overalls, and when I went into the locker room to talk to him, I said, hey, did you bring your lunch pail too? He said, I did, because this is a tough fight. I know what I have to do. His father said, let your hands go. And that's exactly what he's doing here in the 10th round, showing that he still has some stamina left.
This is a great opportunity in the 10th round.
Get your hands
where
back, really.
Garcia now can show and display in championship rounds at this stage of his young career that he's here and he's getting better. And this is a learning place to be. In the 10th round, where I can show a strength, speed and strength, charisma, and now I'm going into this next level.
And this is the type of fight, B-Hop, that I think will help Ryan Garcia reassess where he is. He's been calling out the champions, but you know what? Jason Velez proved that you've got power, but I can take your shots so far. So Ryan Garcia gets the crowd crazy, but this is a real good fight in terms of his growth as a fighter.
It is, because he hit Velez with some good punches that we've seen knock other guys out or down. Tonight, it was different. And that's a learning place that everybody's not going to go down.
Stop.
How do you still figure that out and still continue to win impressively?
I mean, I think it's an impressive performance nonetheless from Ryan Garcia. I have been winning practically every round of this fight. Never been in danger. He's put Velez on shaky legs several times in this fight. But when you're at this point of your career, this is the type of fight that you need. No more patty cakes, no more easy fights. And this is where he really gets to prove who he is. Ryan Garcia, a true prospect.
This fight puts Garcia in the target range of other fighters in his weight division. If I was in his weight division, I would want to fight him, especially if we're in that generation that they are in now.
You want him now, not when he continues to develop. And this guy, who is now the Flash, becomes a monster.
Hello.
The businessman, Bernard Hopkins, as this fight comes to an end. So Ryan Garcia sees the 10 round distance for the first time as a professional. Happy with his performance here at the StubHub Center, but you've got to give Jason Velez a lot of credit. Velez came to fight. Velez made Ryan Garcia prove what he had in the ring. A gut check for this young man. He should come out with flying colors with another victory, but it'll be the judges who have the final word when we return. Been a fun night of action for Golden Boy Boxing on ESPN, presented by Tecate, the official beer of boxing. And it's brought to you by Hennessy. Never stop, never settle. Everyone here in anticipation of what the judges have to say, but first let's take a look at the final punch stats numbers for the first time that Ryan Garcia goes the full 10 round distance. And here's what it looked like, where he landed 29% of his punches, just over 500 thrown, 152 landed. That's exactly, or a little bit more than twice as many as Jason Velez was able to land. But look at those power punch numbers, 120 landed to 54 for Jason Velez, and twice as much in terms of the efficiency at a 35% clip for Ryan Garcia. Now, Ryan Garcia is a social media phenomenon with over 800,000 followers on Instagram. So we went to social media to see what the scorecards look like. And Dan Rayfield has it a shutout, 100-90. Steve Kim, 96-94. Let's go to Joe Martinez with the official judges' scorecards.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, after 10 rounds of boxing, we go to the judges' scorecards. All three judges see it the same, 99-91 for your winner. By unanimous decision, he is now the undefeated NABO, NABF Super Featherweight Champion from Victorville, California, The Flash, Ryan Garcia!
Very sportsmanlike for Jason Velez to put the belt on Ryan Garcia, who improves to 15-0. 13 knockouts. This is the type of performance that will teach him a lot more about who he is as a boxer and where he needs to go as he steps up in level of competition. And now, in the center of the ring, Beto Duran with Ryan Garcia.
Congrats, Ryan. We're gonna knock him out at the distance. The toughest fighter of your career. How do you feel like you did?
I mean, I feel I did great from 1 to 8. I didn't expect for him to be such a durable fighter. Yes, I understand the crowd is going to say what they want. But I'm 19 years old. I got a long way to go. I'm blessed. I want to thank God, but without God, nothing.
Now, Ryan, they love you on social media. They also love to hate you on social media. Why are they booing you?
It's all part of the game, man. I'm still learning. I'm going to put up great fights. Even take my experience further. I want to thank Jason Velez for teaching me how to go longer rounds and how to react. This is going to help me tremendously, and I'm just going to learn from it and continue to trust God.
You're not shy about calling other fighters on social media. You go at it with them. Who do you want to fight?
I want to test my skills, my will, my power, everything, because, you know, in the end of the day, this is a sports competition. If you lose, you lose. You go in here to the head. That's what it's all about, baby.
Ryan Garcia stays undefeated.
He does, and the reviews are mixed in terms of the crowd behind, but I don't think the boos were justified.
But one thing you cannot deny, he has guts. And 19 years old, who's fighting at this level, you're going to have boos, you're going to have cheers. But I think when you all look at it, he's a 19-year-old who's growing fast in his business and his athleticism. I'm just happy to be a part of it as a promoter, also as a commentator, and watching his progress. And I do trust the process.
You do, and you're seeing it happen in Philly as well with the 76ers. But we just saw Oscar De La Hoya, who one of his best pieces of advice for Ryan Garcia was said, I measured my success by the amount of haters I had. And so far, the skill is there, and according to the haters, so is the future of Ryan Garcia. So good night to all of you from Los Angeles. For future Hall of Famer Bernard Hopkins, Beto Duran, and the Golden Boy Media and Entertainment Group, I'm Bernardo Osuna. Ryan Garcia remains undefeated, so we invite you to join us for SportsCenter, which is coming up next. It's been a fun night of action from the StubHub Center in Carson. Until next time.